Now is Dr. Robert Murphy. He is a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Morning.
So it looks like we're getting more vaccine. Have we alleviated our distribution issues in this country?
No, but I think the skeleton structure is there now. We have some experience getting out what's already gotten out there. And by the end of March, we've got some 220 million more doses of Pfizer and Moderna combined, and up to 20 million, 16 to 20 million of the Johnson & Johnson vaccine. That's a lot of vaccine. It's a lot of people getting injections. And you see the numbers go up here in Illinois, number of people being vaccinated. That's happening all around the country, and you're going to see a lot of vaccinations.
We're told you take whatever vaccine comes your way, but should people be concerned if one is this percent effective and I'd rather have this vaccine? Is there enough of a difference where you should be concerned if you get one over the other?
Robin, this is a really great point. We can't say there's any difference between these vaccines because their studies were done at different times of the pandemic. And the first two out of the block, Pfizer and Moderna, were at the beginning when there were relatively few variants floating around in the population. If you repeated those trials today, you don't know. The Johnson & Johnson would be probably the same. It could even possibly be better. I don't know. I mean, I'm just speculating. But there's really not enough difference between them to wait for one or the other. Grab the first one you can get because you don't want to get COVID.
Right. All right, let's take a look at some viewer questions. Could someone slowly build immunity to COVID through repeated minor exposure? After a year of this, trips to grocery stores, I have to believe many of us have been exposed to the virus many times, but not enough at one time to develop symptoms.
I suspect this is coming from a medical professional with some background in this area. And yes, it's true. Minor exposures can give you some kind of immunity. You can measure this when they've done this, like in that scan study I mentioned several weeks ago, a month ago, that a lot of people ended up with antibodies who had no idea that they had COVID, including myself. I was in that study. I never had been sick, and I have antibodies to it. I'm exposed to patients in the hospital. I go to the grocery store, too. So this is all possible. However, so what? You still need the vaccine.
All right, next question. Do you think it would be more prudent to give the Moderna and the Pfizer vaccines to people who have never had COVID and let those of us who have had it and now have our natural antibodies get the Johnson & Johnson vaccine?
Yeah, well, you know, this brings up some very good points. I wouldn't dive into this that deeply. But this is actually kind of what they're doing in the United Kingdom. They're switching vaccines. You know, you get one time, you get one the other time, and then maybe you're going to get a third booster of a different kind. It's all over the place. But really, for right now, just stick with the program. Grab the first vaccine you can get. And if it's a two-dose vaccine or a one-dose vaccine, just take what's out there.
All right, next question. What is the point of high school basketball players wearing a mask during the game if they aren't covering their nose?
Well, the whole thing about masks is how tight they fit. And if you don't cover your nose, you're kind of defeating the whole purpose. You probably do get some benefit, but it's really very limited. So, you know, you just lower the effectiveness of the mask by doing that.
All right. If you have a question for Dr. Murphy, you can post it on our Morning News Facebook page. We'll talk to him again tomorrow at this time. Thanks, doctor.
Thanks, doctor.